In this lesson, we're going to cover optimizing meta titles and meta descriptions. Let's start by defining what meta titles and meta descriptions are. A meta title is the title of the web page that the search engine displays in the SERPs. In Google's search results, meta titles are displayed in blue to indicate that they are hyperlinks. A well-optimized meta title can provide a search engine with important information about your page as well as your brand. Here are some examples of good meta titles. Electric cars, solar panels, and clean energy storage, Tesla. This excellent meta title conveys everything Tesla is about in 22 words and includes the brand name. Online learning, creative classes on Skillshare start for free. Again, this meta title contains everything you need to know about Skillshare as well as a very compelling call to action. Start for free. A meta description, on the other hand, is the text that appears below the meta title. A good meta description sums up what the page is about. Here are a couple of examples of good meta descriptions. This one's from Lonely Planet. Love travel? Discover, plan, and book your perfect trip with expert advice, travel guides, destination information, and inspiration from Lonely Planet. And this one from Hello Fresh. UK's leading recipe box, fresh quality ingredients, even more recipe choice and variety, flexible subscription, free delivery, get started now. For SEO purposes, Google gives high priority to a title, so a well-crafted meta title should include your target keyword. Additionally, if you can add a compelling element to your title, you could see a boost in click-through rate, which will help your rankings. Similarly, your meta description should contain your target keyword. Although these days, Google uses the meta description for display purposes only. But don't underestimate its use, because the meta description has prime space in the SERPs after all. It's an opportunity for you to reinforce and expand the meta title to make sure you get the click. Also, the keyword in your meta description will display in bold whenever a search query matches it. This can make your meta description more eye-catching and influence the click. Now let's look at some basic guidelines for writing good meta titles for SEO. 1. Keep in mind the 600 pixel width limit for displaying a meta title in the SERPs. A good rule of thumb is to keep your meta titles to 60 characters or less in order to stay within that limit. If your title is longer, Google will truncate your title. 2. Remember to add your brand name when titling product or service pages. 3. Be mindful of using absolute words like best, top, and ultimate in your titles. These can appear spammy and, let's face it, whether something is the best or not is almost always subjective. Consider using words like recommended, trending, etc. instead. And here are some mistakes to avoid when crafting your meta titles. 1. Avoid creating duplicate titles. This is easy to do on platforms such as WordPress, where you may be cloning an existing page or post to save time. Duplicate content can, at worst, get you penalized in a search engine, or at best, your duplicate content won't rank. 2. Don't create meta titles that are too long, as they'll truncate in the SERPs. But also avoid titles that are too short, as that's a waste of prime real estate and a wasted opportunity to entice searchers to click. 3. Avoid clickbait titles, as these can result in no clicks. Or if you do a good job of your clickbait, lots of clicks, which then result in a high bounce rate when searchers realize the overpromise. Both of these scenarios can cause your rankings to drop. Now let's look at some basic guidelines for writing meta descriptions for SEO. 1. Keep your descriptions to a maximum of 160 characters. 2. Use an active voice rather than a passive one. An active voice is one where the subject is performing an action. For example, we are changing the way you use the web. 3. Use a call to action whenever possible. For example, start today or click for details. 4. Do include the main keywords in the meta description. For example, we sell casual clothing for men. 5. Add specifications if the description is for a product page. For example, size or color. Now, sometimes, despite our best efforts to craft a great meta title and description, Google replaces those with some text from your page. The most likely reason for this happening is a failure to follow the guidelines I've just given you. But when that's not the case, Google may be presenting the text that is best suited to the searcher's intent, which may sometimes be different to the one that you catered for in your title and description. In that case, Google thinks your content is a good match for the searcher, even if your title and description aren't. In the next lesson, we'll be covering keyword density optimization. I'll see you there.